strong and get healthy. Stretch. Feel great about yourself and have some fun. It's time for you. Fitness is the key to your future. Don't get locked out. Take the challenge. Commit to be fit. Hi, I'm Susie Smith, and thanks for joining me today on Commit to Be Fit. Each month, I try to bring something different to the show to help inspire someone or reach out to someone. And today's show is very interesting. I have a super inspiring person here with possible life-saving information. And she's just a regular person like you and me, and she's a volunteer like everyone else at BPTV. But she's come on today to give us some information on something that she's done, something that a lot of people wish that they could do. So I'd like to introduce to you my guest, Michelle Kuhns. Hi, Michelle.
Hi.
Hi, thank you for coming on the show.
Oh, thank you for having me.
So tell us, why are you here today?
Well, I have lost over 100 pounds since September 26, 2014.
Not even a year?
No.
Wow. September 26, 2014.
Yes.
How much weight? Over 100?
I lost 112, but I have gained 2 pounds back. I'm kind of at a plateau right now, but I'm working past that.
Wow. That is amazing. People tell me all the time, like, how can I lose 10 pounds? And here, you know, you just... It's unbelievable to me when I heard that you had lost that much weight. Mm-hmm. But you look fantastic. I guess what I want to know is, how did you gain the weight? Like, what, if we start at the beginning, like, how did that happen?
Well,
were you always heavy, or were you?
I started to gain weight in high school. As the years went on, I yo-yo dieted back and mm-hmm. forth. I've lost weight, gained weight, and pretty much all of my adult life, I've been heavy, and within the past 3 years, I have put on over 30 pounds, and it was just getting out of control.
What happened, like, that made you, like, what do you think happens to people that start to gain weight? Does it just happen and you don't really realize it until you've gained 50 pounds? You know, it just comes on?
I think for some people, it's just the standard American diet, which is referred to as SAD, ironically.
Really? SAD?
Yes. it's lots and lots of carbs mm-hmm. and sugar and hidden sugar, mm-hmm. Fast food, convenient food. Just things like that, and it's easy to have access to that type of food, which makes a lot of people jump to that type of a diet. Mm-hmm. And what I've learned is that you don't have to be a professional chef, but do most of your eating and cooking at home, and that just really helps a lot.
That's great advice. So what approach did you take with food? Not that I am not a nutritionist, so I can't really advocate any certain diet, but you're saying that mostly you cut out some things?
I try to follow a low-carb diet, which in the beginning, you lose a lot of water weight, and it's amazing how much you lose the first few weeks of doing a low carb, which helps a lot of people because
you get
the motivation.
Yeah. Wow. So are you under a doctor's care?
I wasn't in the beginning. I actually started seeing my family doctor on a monthly basis in April because I wanted to see what medications I could come off of that I had previously been on.
So you were on medications for?
I have type 2 diabetes, mm-hmm. Moderate to severe arthritis in both knees, which for the diabetes, I was on a special kind of insulin called unit 500 insulin, mm-hmm. which is five times more potent than traditional unit 100 insulin. And I had to take that with an insulin pump. And
I remember that. Are you still on that?
No. I was able to discontinue all insulin.
Really?
In October, only a month after starting a low-carb diet.
So 1 month?
1 month.
How much did you lose that first month?
The first month I lost around, I'd say 25 to 30 pounds.
Okay, so that gave you the impetus to keep going.
Right.
And then you got off that medication.
Got off the medicine, which
wow.
I think that insulin doesn't cause weight gain, but it makes it harder to lose mm-hmm. weight. I do still take medication for the arthritis, but it's 95% better now. I'm mm-hmm. able to stand and walk and run and do things I wasn't able to do before.
See, that's one of my big questions. I'm not interested, I'm interested in what you ate mm-hmm. but I know that information is out there. Mm-hmm. I think the main thing that I'm interested in is like the mental thing, because people know, they are given diets by their doctors
right.
or they know how to lose weight, but they can't maintain. So I guess my question to you is, how did you stay determined through that whole thing? Like, where did you find that?
Well, with the weight coming off so quickly in the beginning, that was my main motivation mm-hmm. to keep going.
It was like an instant reward almost.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Just going into a store and trying on a size smaller or two sizes smaller mm-hmm. and they fit or they're too big.
Yeah.
That was a big inspiration. I enjoy going outside, taking my dogs for walks, and being able to do that without knee pain was wonderful.
That's definitely one of the questions, that I had about how does it feel? Because when I think of 100 pounds, I think of 2 50-pound bags of dog food because mm-hmm. you and I are dog lovers. But you were carrying 2 50-pound bags of dog food around with you, mm-hmm. if you can imagine that, or anything else that would weigh 100 pounds. You have to feel like you're flying.
I do. I definitely feel a lot better. I actually have a dog at home who weighs 100 pounds, and I can't even pick him up.
Really?
And I can't imagine carrying him around
wow.
all the time. It's just, as the mm-hmm. weight comes off, you notice little things, so it's not a big difference all the time.
You told me that there was, I guess one day there was something that actually made it click in your brain mm-hmm. that this was going to happen for you and you were going to do it. And what was that?
When I went and had my driver's license picture taken and they showed me the picture on the screen, and I was mortified. I couldn't believe that I had let myself get to that point to, I think I weighed around 280 pounds at that point. And the picture kept going through my mind. That can't be me, but it
yeah.
was.
You actually look 30 years younger. Mm-hmm. It's just unbelievable. But how do you see yourself?
I know that I'm a lot healthier. Mm-hmm. And I know that I look better. I still have 40 pounds that I'd like to lose.
Really?
I know I'll never look like I did back in middle school and high school, but it would be nice to.
I think you actually look better. You have such good poise to you, and your posture's really, really good, and just your skin and everything. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
I really couldn't wait to get on TV to tell you that, but does your diet ever, do you get stuck? You say you have plateaus sometimes?
Yes, I had one in February mm-hmm. Where I went about a week with eating junk food and stuff mm-hmm. that I shouldn't have, but
sometimes you just have right. to let go.
Yeah, and I'm kind of at a plateau right now, but I'm getting the motivation back to get through that. I've had some traumatic events happen recently, and
I know
things are smoothing out now. Yeah. So it's,
and that makes it hard when things happen in your life. And I know that that's happening to a lot of people that are listening today. Mm-hmm. They're thinking, did you ever think that you couldn't do it? I know a lot of people are thinking, I can't do that.
I never really thought I could do it, so I never even bothered to try. And there's just that point where it's like, it's, you've got to try and see what happens.
And how do you stay determined?
I think back to how I felt when I was at 280 pounds. It was hard to just stand up from sitting down. I wasn't able to stand in one spot because of the pain, the constant needles and insulin and all of the medications. I don't think I could ever go back to that. And I just want to get healthier and be around.
Yeah, you definitely, you have a lot to live for. I know you're married and you have lots of animals to take care of. And I, the same situation, I'm married and have lots of animals. And it takes a lot of energy to get up every day and get through all of your chores.
Definitely.
And even just bending over and like putting shoes on and things like that, or walking up a flight of steps, is everything just a breeze now?
Yeah, I can go down steps rather quickly. And before, I'd have to take them one at a time. And I felt like an 80-year-old woman trapped inside of a 35-year-old body. And I felt a lot older than I really was. And I think that a lot of people saw that by the way that I presented myself, the way that I dressed, the way that I had my hair. And it's just, I'm not old yet. I don't want to be there.
This is you. This is like, this is fantastic. And I hope that we can inspire some people today to just kind of take a look at their life. And if there's something that you want to change, whether it be, you know, losing weight or maybe quitting smoking or just something that you need to change in your life to be healthier, that you want to tap into this, what Michelle has tapped into. And like for so many years, you felt that you couldn't do this. And then you saw that picture. And that was the impetus that got you started.
Yes.
Did you start like right away? After?
Yes. When I saw the picture and I left the driver's license center, I went straight to the store and bought a lot of low-carb products. And I did some research on the internet about low-carb dieting. And I've heard about it before, which is why I decided to go with that, because I heard that a lot of people that have diabetes can succeed to lose weight and also take less or no medication by following a low-carb diet.
Well, another thing I wanted to ask you, if you're, when we talk about plateaus, if your low-carb diet stops working for you, because, you know, sometimes after you do something for a while, you don't get the results that you did in the beginning. Would you be willing to try something else, like go to your doctor and figure how to, you know, not lose what you...
Yes.
What you got? And
I've been looking at different approaches to weight loss online. I don't like to say the word diet because it's not a diet. It's a lifestyle change. And, you know, there's things that I've cut out, like food groups that I've cut out with the low carb that I'd like to slowly add back in. But like you said, I don't want to regain weight, and I'd still like to continue losing. So I am open to different approaches to weight loss, definitely.
Good. Well, what are your thoughts on exercise? Has exercise played any part in your weight loss?
It has. I I was given a treadmill, which I like to walk on the treadmill when I can't get outside, when it's too cold, or when it's too hot or just rainy. And I recently purchased an elliptical machine.
Oh, which, those are good.
Which gives you a really intense leg workout, I will say.
And a heart workout, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can really feel your heart rate getting up on this.
And my husband bought me a swimming pool for our anniversary, which haven't had the greatest weather for, but the past few days have been nice.
I know. We had to wait till the end of July for summer to come.
Yeah.
But so when you were, now I find that this has happened to me when I've tried to reach goals in my life as far as competitions and things, and and I was monitoring my food. Do people support you, or do, if you are around people, do they say, oh, go ahead, you can have, like, go ahead, have that, you know, sandwich or bowl of ice cream, or do they support you?
It's kind of 50-50. There's people that know that I'm not eating the way that I used to, and they'll try to keep like sweets and things like that away when I'm around. I do get tempted at times, but then you have to fight through the temptations, or you know, every now and then it's, you know, you have to treat yourself to something. But but then there's ones that don't really acknowledge you know, what I'm doing, and I wouldn't say that they don't care, but they just
they just don't understand.
Yeah.
So what kind of advice do you have, like, if somebody out there is listening, and I know they are, I know a few people in particular that are waiting to watch this show, and they want to lose weight, but they think that you need to have a gym membership, you need to have a personal trainer, you need to buy food out of cans and all that. How do you feel about all of that infomercial stuff about weight loss?
I think there's just so many things out there that are a way to make money and not really help the person that's purchasing their product. I would say, I mean, I've heard a saying that great abs start in the kitchen, which I definitely don't have great abs, but
you probably do. Well, as much work as you do, they're in there.
They're under there somewhere. But
you know, you really shouldn't see people's abdominals, really, in real life. You know, that is for on stage and bodybuilding, or if you want to stand at the beach and attract attention. But that's really not what real people look like.
No, not at all.
Yeah, and that's what we have to get past, I think, that... Right. You know, you don't have to have a six pack. You can have a two pack.
Right.
You can have a one pack. You know, that's, you don't, but don't you think a lot of that is just like,
it's a lot of hype.
A lot of hype and a lot of money making.
Right.
So you didn't do any of that. You didn't buy any, videos of,
insanity videos.
Yeah, crazy workouts.
No.
And, you know, all that, and beat yourself up. You just took a sensible approach.
Mm-hmm.
You just went to your doctor.
Changed the way that I was eating.
Mm-hmm.
One thing that I never did before that I do now is drink lots and lots of water.
That was my next question.
It's very hard in the beginning, and trust me, it gets easier. It does. I drink approximately 7 to 8 bottles of water a day.
Okay.
I'm a big diet soda fanatic, which I'm trying to get away from, but it's hard. But the water has made an amazing difference, not only in the weight loss, but in my skin.
That's what I was going to say. Your skin is glowing.
I used to have really dry, like patchy, just yucky skin. And
your skin's so clear now. It's just like radiant, and that's from the water.
The hydration of the water.
Now, I used to be, and you know, I used to be a Diet Pepsi fanatic. It'll be 3 years next month I quit.
Wow.
Totally went cold turkey off of diet soda. And it was hard, but I still drink tea. I like my black tea, but I try to really pound down a lot of water. And that gives me energy because, you know, your body's built up of a lot of water. I forget what percentage, but
I think like 80%, they say.
Yeah, of water, because that's what, you know, we are.
And it helps to drink a bottle. If you can't drink a whole bottle, you know, start with half a bottle, but to drink before you eat your meal or your snack, and you will eat less because it fills you up. On days that I don't get my 7 to 8 bottles, I do feel a lot more hungry than normally I would, so it really helps.
Because they say a lot of times you think you're hungry, but really you're just thirsty.
Right.
I don't know why people in our country don't drink much water, but I do talk to a lot of people that don't drink any water. They drink coffee and maybe orange juice or something, but no water. And I think, you know, you really have to have the water.
Right.
So will you continue like this for life? Is this a life-changing thing for you?
The approach that I took with the low carb, I'd like to stick with that because I feel better when I eat that way. I don't get bloated and just the feeling like you have a big rock in your stomach after you eat a lot of bread and stuff like that.
Yeah, you do feel that way.
I would like to add more fruits into my diet because my family owns a peach and apple orchard, which it's hard not to eat the fruits.
You can say the name of their apple orchard.
Krenzlach Orchards in Prosperity, PA.
Because they have excellent fruit.
They
I know
do.
That.
I'd like to add some healthy whole grain type things. I did find like a flatbread thing that I wrap my husband's lunch meat in for his sandwiches that I think it has flax and oat in it and stuff like that I'd like to slowly add back in because you can't just eat meat and eggs and stuff like that forever. You have to get a balanced diet.
Well, I think that is really, you've hit on something here. It's because I don't think that you can stay on any kind of diet forever.
No.
And so you've hit on a really important point that once you get yourself under control and your body feels comfortable where you are, you'll be able to stay there.
Yes.
You really needed to lose that weight, though, to get rid of the diabetes. You're not diabetic, or you are?
I am. I was at my endocrinologist last week, and she said that my A1C was that of a person without diabetes. And
I don't
take any medication for the diabetes.
Look what you've done. I am so proud of you. I can't tell you. I was so excited to do this show because this is something that people need. Our country is getting really overweight.
Yes.
And sometimes, you know, people, it's genetic. Sometimes it's not. Some people are naturally skinny. But I think we have to find a balance. You know, you don't want to be too thin. You don't want to be too heavy. And when you were at 280, that had to probably affect your internal organs, put a lot of pressure on you, the arthritis.
Yes.
You know, and just the fact that I know that you do home improvement.
Yeah.
And I don't think that you could do that before.
Oh, no.
Weren't you hanging shutters recently?
Yes, I put up shutters on our house. I tore up carpet and replaced the floors. Just painting, things like
that. I saw you putting trim down. You were putting trim.
Yeah, put down trim. I'd like to say that I used to groom dogs, and I wasn't even able to get down on the ground to sit on the floor to do a nail trim, which...
you always did in the beginning.
Yeah, I could always do that before. Yeah. And now I can, you know, get down on the floor, get back up.
Well, you must feel so You must feel so in control of your life. Do you feel like more in control of other aspects of your life since you know that you can do this and you're in control of yourself and your emotional eating and all that? You've got that under control?
Right. There's days, but that happens to everybody. But yeah, I can walk into a convenience store to pay for gas or get a drink of water or Diet Coke or something and walk past the candy bars and walk past the chips, and it doesn't affect me. Whereas before, I'd have to get a candy bar. Anytime we went somewhere where they sold junk food, I felt the need to get something. Not anymore.
I am so glad. We're going to wrap up the show here in a minute, and I just want to tell you how proud I am of you that you could do this and focus and to lose all that weight. And I know you still have some more to go.
Yeah.
But on an ending note, what would you, what kind of advice would you give to people to get started? Somebody's watching today and maybe they're 100 pounds overweight. Did you feel like, did you ever feel defeated?
There were days that I felt like just giving up and it wasn't worth it. And usually that would happen when I get hungry, which usually is more towards the end of the day. And I would say to people that feel like they can't do this, just give it a try. Drink the water. Trust me, drink the water. And just stick with it. If you mess up, that's okay, but just stick with it the best you can. You know, everything works differently for different people. A low-carb approach might not be right for some people, but...
So check with your doctor.
Right, check with your doctor. Exercise is important, but it begins with changing the way that you eat, changing your lifestyle, cooking at home, taking a lunch rather than ordering out, and just adding new healthy foods into your diet that you normally wouldn't eat before. And it's amazing that some of the things that you'll like that you never tried before or that you thought you didn't like or you didn't like as a kid. But
so maybe you swap something out.
Right, just try it. Just stick with it and try it.
I think a big thing is to believe in yourself, and it seems like you've done that. You realize that you had the power.
Right. Just you can't worry about what other people think of you. You just got to, you know, continue doing what you're doing and focus on yourself and, you know, love yourself. You know, you can't beat up yourself and be hard on yourself. You got to, you know, take care of you.
Mm-hmm. Because you're the only you that you have.
Right.
This is your life and you want to be in control of it. So I want to thank you for coming on the show today and sharing all of this possible life-saving information, because I don't know where you would be if you stayed at that weight, you know, with a diabetic situation.
And probably wouldn't make it past 40, 45 years old, I don't think.
Mm-hmm. Now you're on your way to a long life. So, well, thank you again, Michelle.
Well, thank
you. I appreciate you being here, and I hope you come back on for an update, because I know you still have more weight to lose.
Yes, I do.
And I would just like to tell everybody out there, I hope that you're inspired today to do something to make a change in your life if there is a change to be made. And whether it's stopping smoking or losing weight, try to tap into that inner power that you have, that we all have. And remember, take the challenge and commit to be fit.